Do your customers sometimes return merchandise to you? Of course, everyone has customers who sometimes return merchandise. That's why you should watch this video, Refunding Merchandise Sales in QuickBooks. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Refunding merchandise sales is very simple if it's a credit sale, meaning it's very simple to record if the original sale was recorded on an invoice. The additional step is if it's a cash sale refund, and we will cover both of those issues right here in this video. Refunding credit sales invoice means the original sale was recorded by making an invoice. The refund should be recorded by making a credit memo. Credit memo should have the same items as on the original invoice from the original sale. The effect of the credit memo is the opposite of the invoice. The sales income for that item will decrease by the sales price of the items that are returned. The cost of goods sold will decrease by the weighted average purchase cost of the items that were just returned. And the inventory quantity will actually increase because if a customer gives back merchandise, you now have more merchandise available for sale in inventory. Now here's our example. Let's imagine on July 1, 2019, Alan returned 3 bananas from the sale made on June 3rd, 2015, where we made an invoice for that sale. The sales income account will decrease by $300 because that was the price of the bananas returned. The cost of goods sold account will decrease by $60 because that was the purchase cost of the bananas that Alan returned. And the inventory quantity for bananas will increase by 3 because if a customer returns 3 items, there are 3 more available for sale. So watch how we do this in QuickBooks Desktop. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Credit Memo. Now, we have to choose, first we should put in the date. It was July 1 of 2019. And the customer was Alan. I believe the customer was Alan, yes. And the item that was returned was bananas. And the quantity of the item returned was 3. So you can see $300 will decrease the balance of sales income. When I click Save and Close, you get this question. Now, we will check the numbers in a moment, but please note, refunds from invoice sales should be retained as a credit. This way, they can be applied to the customer's invoices and balances. And if you're not sure about the details, please see the Accounts Receivable course for more details on how to manage customers' credits and balances. But in the meantime, let's make sure these numbers happen in QuickBooks. So we click Retain as an Available Credit and click OK. Now when we open the trial balance and open the sales account, double click, go to the very bottom. The very last transaction in the sales income account was this credit memo decreasing the sales income by the sales price of the 3 bananas that were returned. We can also double-click the cost of goods sold account and look at the very bottom and see the very last transaction in the cost of goods sold account is a credit memo decreasing the cost of goods sold by the amount that we paid for the bananas that were returned. And finally, if we open the inventory valuation detail and look at the very last transaction for bananas, we see there's an increase in quantity by 3 because a customer just gave us 3 more bananas. Now, in the case of a cash sale refund, you make a credit memo the same way as if it were a credit invoice sale. Again, the effect reverses the sale in the accounts and in the inventory quantity exactly the way we saw a moment ago. You make the same credit memo as in a credit sale from an invoice, however, the additional step for a cash refund is to have QuickBooks issue a refund. This will record a write a check transaction to decrease the cash in bank for the amount of the sale return. So take a look at this example. Let's imagine on July 2nd of 2019, Candy returned 4 apples from the sale made to her on June 1, 2015. We make a credit memo, but when we finish the credit memo, we will instead click Issue a Refund. And you will notice something interesting. So let's go ahead and make the customer create credit memo refund. And this is, what's the date here? The date is July 2nd of 2019. And the customer is Candy. And the item that she's returning is apples. And how many apples? 4 apples. So the quantity that she's returning is 4. Now, we already know sales goes down by 200. Now look what happens when we click save and close. We get this choice, but this time, because we're refunding a cash sale and giving back money, we will click give a refund and then click OK. Now this box comes up, and what this enables us to do is print a check that we can give to Candy for $200, and it gives us the ability to decrease the bank account by the amount that we're actually refunding. Of course, you would choose cash in bank instead of undeposited funds if that's where the money from the refund would come from. And then we click OK. Now, I could show you the accounts and again repeat the reverse effect that you saw a moment ago. But the interesting thing is that the cost of goods sold actually decreased by what the current average cost is, not by what the average cost was back on June 1, 2015. So you have to keep that in mind when you do your accounting. When I open the trial balance and double click cost of goods sold and scroll to the bottom, you can see this last credit memo decreases the cost of goods sold, but not by $40 for 4 apples. It decreased it by $43.74, because even though it was refunding something from far in the past, when you create a credit memo for a refund for a customer, it will use the current average cost. And that's something to think about and consider. You should also consider that you can double click and open the check and see exactly what QuickBooks did. If you're interested, we can go here to cash in bank, double click and scroll to the very last transaction. It says credit refund. And notice if we double click, oh, you see this opens up here, and this is the same thing as writing a check. However, you must do it this way, because if you try to write a check yourself instead of doing it the way I just showed, you cannot directly write this check yourself because you cannot put a negative quantity of merchandise in the bottom of a check. So it's very easy to do, but there's a lot to consider when you give a cash refund for a cash sale of merchandise.